let's go to crack television. So different mode of defense now. So instead of sprawling, right, week to week, there's another option here defensively in the basketball, and that's also a crack television. So this is why, as an offensive guy, it's super important for you to keep weight and pressure across the body. And I'm sure that someone said, keep your shoulder inside the hip. So we're going to try to do the opposite of that. We're trying to beat him in. So Mario's going to head out to the table here. Now, my goal here is different than when I was sprawling. Right? When I was sprawling, I was getting his head down, go to my right, right? Now I'm not going to my right, I'm going to my left. Right? And what's going to happen here is I want to get all my weight, or a lot of my weight, on my right foot. When my weight's on my right foot, I can put my left foot up, and actually I can step forward on my left foot, which is what I'm trying to use. As I do that, I'm going to change the direction of my hips. And my goal is to get his weight to go this direction. I want to get his weight to go forward. As his weight goes forward, I'm going to sit to my right butt cheek, and I'm going to pull him down or throw him down to his head. From here, my right hand is going to go to his back. My left hand is going to go to his butt cheek. So I step forward with my left foot. Now watch. My left foot steps forward here, and then I pivot. Whereas I kind of turn my foot on my heel. And what's happening is I'm opening my hips up.
Yeah.
You see how my hips now are perpendicular
to my car.
Not in front of me. Right? And then I'm going to sit my right butt cheek, my right butt cheek, and I'm going to throw his weight forward. I want all his weight towards his head. This is why the head outside single is such a dangerous. This is such a dangerous defense because this guy gets in deep, gets a good shot, but if his weight is just
not
distributed properly, he can end up here. Right? Even if he does everything right, he can still end up here. Right? It's a really tough defense for this guy to beat. Right hand to the lat, left hand to the butt cheek. Notice how when I step forward, I'm really making my stance here. I sit my right butt cheek, my right butt cheek over. Now let's look here. My right butt cheek is on the mat, not my left butt cheek, okay? From here, I will lock in the crotch, and I'll have weight in towards my opponent. I'm really driving off my left foot, and I'm driving weight towards his head. His goal, should I take him to a crack down position, which I did, his goal is he doesn't want this to happen, what just happened left. Notice his shoulder is outside of my hip. Right? His goal is going to be to keep his shoulder inside my hip. If he keeps his shoulder inside my hip, he gets weight towards both butt cheeks. Now, I not only don't have an angle, I can't usually lock in the crotch. I may be able to, but may not. I'm usually right here. Now, he's probably in a command position here, and he's looking to elevate my weight towards my butt here. As he does that, look, I'm in trouble, I'm in trouble, I'm in trouble here. Now he can score. Right? I don't want that. I'm trying to get to the side of him. So when I pivot, I sit to my right butt cheek, my right butt cheek, and I throw his weight in this direction. Right hand to the lap. Left hand to the butt cheek. I'm going to step forward, pivot, and sit. Step forward, pivot, sit. Notice, I didn't take my right foot backwards. I pivoted on it, and it's underneath him. It's also underneath me. My left butt cheek is on the mat, and my left foot is up. I want to be tight here. I want to have a tight position. I don't want my position to look like this, because this guy will really take his arm over, and he'll really reach through that far end. Or if nothing else, will reach under him. So I want to keep tight position here. My left foot, notice my left foot is posted on that, it's up high. Now, from here, I'm going to score by scooting and getting really around him and behind him. As I'm here, there'll be a lot of little adjustments. I'll scoot, 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 as I scoot, I'll step over. My left foot steps over, notice my left foot steps over his leg. I'm controlling his hips now. From here, I can probably let go. My right hand will let go and it'll post. Notice how I came over the top of his body and posted here. And I'm using this to help drive. I'll drive up and into my opponent, I drive into him, and I look to score, right? Offensive guy, do me a favor, stay somewhat solid here. I have people that, this guy takes you to crack position, and you fall to your left hip, that'll never happen. If Mario falls left hip, that won't happen. His goal is actually to try to fall to his right hip. He puts his right hip down, his right shoulder stays inside my hip, then it's tough to beat. You're probably going to end up on two knees here, all right? So, my right hand's going to go to the lat, my left hand's going to go to the butt cheek. I'm going to step forward with my left foot. I'm not pulling my leg back. So, you guys are pulling your leg back. I'm not pulling my leg back. I'm pivoting on my right foot. Right hand to the lat, left hand to the butt cheek. I step forward, I pivot, I sit, I lock in the crotch here. Notice how my chest is up high. I have him in a position that's not very favorable for him. I'm not going to let him ever try to get his shoulder back inside my hip. That's why I'm so tight to him right here. I'm not going to be able to scoot and drive my way to my left. I'm driving into him here off my left foot. From here, I step over, I hook, and now I'll post and I'll drive. Let's do it. One, two, three.
Go off.